Anyone who is waiting for the Black Friday deals window in 2025 to build a new PC is probably going to be disappointed this year, mostly because memory prices have just about tripled in the past month or month and a half. But that doesn't mean there aren't any deals. While memory prices are way up, SSD prices are up somewhat, there are some other good alternatives in there. So I have once again made a Black Friday deals spreadsheet that's linked in the video description if you'd like to jump right to it, and I'll be updating that all weekend. Stick around while I cover some of the highlights.
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware Store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise. Tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now.
So here it is, my Black Friday deals spreadsheet. Again, I'll be updating this all weekend. It is very much a work in progress. You may note like the memory deals, pretty non-existent here, although I will be adding the best of what is available to this list. But if you're looking for some solid choices, there are some good deals on CPUs. We have a handful of graphics cards deals as well. We don't have very many storage deals, especially if you're comparing to last year, but it's not horrible. And then towards the bottom, we have some cases, we have some power supplies, we have some monitors, and we have a catch-all miscellaneous section at the bottom. So jumping right into it with CPUs, this deal has been already on for like a week or two now, since a lot of the Black Friday deals start earlier in November this time of year. But the 9800X3D is the best CPU for gaming. It's pretty widely accepted to be that. $30 off is not fantastic, but it's better than paying full price, and it is readily available. You also have the 7800X3D if you're looking for something close to the 9800X3D, but you want to save a few bucks. This is down to about $376. The cheapest I've ever seen this was $360, so it's pretty close to that. That is not too bad as well. If you're looking for something a little bit more entry level to get onto the AM5 platform and maybe consider an upgrade in the future down the line, a 6-core is going to be the way to go there. The 7600X is your best choice right now in terms of lowest price for about $180. Other alternative is the 9600X. That is $195 right now, which isn't fantastic, but it is among the lowest prices that I've seen that at. We even have some Intel deals. I haven't been very complimentary of Intel's current platform with the Core Ultra series of processors, but if you can find a good, inexpensive motherboard deal to combine with a Core Ultra processor, it can provide a somewhat compelling alternative to AMD if you're not planning to do an upgrade path in the future, since the platform these CPUs slot into is probably going to be end of life by the middle or end of 2026. Do note that some of these include a promo code. It's an instant promo code, so you just got to enter that in checkout, or sometimes it does it automatically, but that brings the 265K down to $260, and then also pay attention to, if you scroll down, they have these combo offers that might give you additional savings. So right now it's pairing the 265K with a Z890 Gaming Plus motherboard, giving you a motherboard CPU combo for about $370. There was an AIO that this was being paired with earlier as well. It looks like Newegg has sort of modified how their combo deals work, and there's just a bunch of different things that you can combo it with. I'm not going to go over every single one of those. But likewise, the 285K is down to its low price. I believe this is the lowest price we've seen it. $500 after the $80 off promo code. And yes, there are a bunch of combo deals that can be combined with that one as well. Moving over to GPUs, I'm just going to highlight a couple of these, and I have a lot more to add to the list. But the RX 9070 is a 16 gig graphics card, and it's down to $520. Fantastic. This is only about $30 less than its MSRP, but if you've seen my GPU Price Watch series that I've been doing for most of this year, you might know that the RX 9070 was really resisting its MSRP for quite some time. So it now being $30 lower than that makes it a compelling deal, and definitely something to consider if you're looking at something like an RTX 5070 on the Nvidia side. Speaking of the Nvidia side, if you see good deals on Nvidia graphics cards, again, check my GPU Price Watch, the most recent episode for November, because this RTX 5060 Ti is the 8GB model, and you should avoid 8GB models if you can and go for higher VRAM allocation if possible right now. But this one seemed to have a fair amount of interest in it, and it is already sold out just within the past hour or two since I first pulled this up. It's supposed to be $340 minus $20 brings it down to $320. The MSRP for the 5060 Ti 8GB is $380. And you know, that seems like a good deal until you realize, oh, that was the low price back in September. This isn't exactly new. How much is the 16GB version going for? Oh, it's sold out too. It also has a promo code. I'll add this one to the list as well, just in case it comes back in stock. I would definitely veer towards this option or consider, of course, the 9060 XT 16 gig. Moving past the CPUs and GPUs though, we have an AIO here from Cooler Master. This is also a fantastic deal. Usually 100 bucks down to about 67, and it's the Master Liquid from Cooler Master. They make really solid AIOs. I have some air coolers down on the list as well for people who might lean towards air cooling or just spending a few fewer dollars. Here's some SSD deals for storage. A 4 terabyte SATA SSD is probably the best bang for your buck when it comes to NAND-based storage that is not overpriced. $195 for 4 terabytes, pretty solid from Best Buy. Here's a Silicon Power 4 terabyte UD90. This is a bit more on the budget range of NVMe SSDs, but this is one that was like $190 last year, jumped up to like $290 as of a week or so ago, and it's dropped by $30. So you can look at that as an increase or a decrease depending on how far back you go. But still, this is one of the cheapest 4 terabyte NVMe SSDs on the market. If you're looking for something more reasonable in the 2 terabyte range, 2 terabyte NVMe's were like $85, $90, $95. So this hasn't gone up that much if you compare it to memory pricing, but $116 for this King spec model isn't too bad either. And then if you're looking for mass storage, how about $10 per terabyte for a 24 terabyte Seagate Barracuda hard drive, a SATA hard drive. Just make sure you give yourself plenty of time if you're gonna do a full format on that. Budget builders might still look to the last gen AM4 platform for some deals. And if you're looking for a platform for your AM4 build, about a $100 B550-A Pro. It's a pretty solid choice. Here is a good case from Montech that includes 4 fans. Usually sells for $75, down to $70. Another $6 coupon brings it down to about $64. Pretty solid there. The Height Y40 is, I guess they, can you just say your product is S tier? Height apparently has no problem doing that. This case usually sells for $130, and it is a very good case. It's available for $99, depending on where you're looking. So you have various color choices. This one's available directly from Amazon for $99. And even like the black version that's not available directly from Amazon, if you click see more options, you can get it from the Newegg Business Marketplace for that same price of $100. We do have some solid power supply deals. A $70 750 watts. It's 80 plus bronze rated, but not terrible. The MSI Mag series does have a 12V 2x6 power connector if you're going for an NVIDIA graphics card. If you're looking for a higher wattage power supply, the Thermaltake Tough Power 1000 watt is the Tough Power GT. 80 plus gold also has that 12V 2x6 connector for $110, down from $150. Thermaltake also has their GX2, which is also 80 plus gold, down to $50 over on Newegg. So this is a very solid budget choice. Moving over to some monitors, and I feel like monitors is the place where there actually are some really good deals where it's like, wow, what can you get for $146? 2560x1440, 180 hertz refresh rate. This is an IPS panel, and 27 inches 2560x1440 is excellent pixel density. So this is a fantastic gaming monitor for really less than $150. We have a Dell 4K 27 inch that's down to $200, marked down from $300. This is also an IPS panel, 120 hertz refresh rate, but you get more pixels at 3840x2160. And then the larger version of this is 32 inch class, or 31.5 inch specifically. Also 4K 120 hertz. This is a VA panel rather than an IPS, but it is an excellent price at $250, marked down from $370. And then we have some peripherals. The Asus ROG Strix Scope 2 is a very highly rated mechanical keyboard, and this is usually over $200, marked down to $129. I guess I should say $130. And then if you're looking for like how to get RAM and not overpay for it, mini PCs and integrated PCs that haven't been marked up yet is one way to go there. So while this is an Amazon Prime deal, it is a mini gaming PC, which includes a 7840HS, which has integrated graphics, 32 gigs of DDR5 RAM. Like, wow, I feel like 32 gig kits sell for this much right now. You also get a 1 terabyte SSD. So $440, I feel like it's worth it just for the RAM. We also have some cool little accessories, maybe some stocking stuffer type things. This is an Acer 4-port USB 3.0 hub, down to $10. It's almost like an impulse buy on checkout or something. We also have this Anker deal on USB-C cables. If you want some solid 3-foot USB-C cables that can do up to 240 watts fast charging. They're also braided. Ooh, pretty. 10 bucks, also an Amazon Prime deal. But if you want to know what like the best possible deal is, the way you can save the most money this Black Friday season, head on over to Best Buy. Check out this Hisense 136 inch micro LED TV. It's only $100,000, but look, it's only $100,000, but look, it's usually $150,000, which means you save $50,000 just on this one item. I think I'm gonna buy four of these to save $200,000, and I'm gonna use that $200,000 to invest in buying system RAM. That seems like the best use of my money for this Black Friday cycle. But that's all I've got for now. Once again, this list is going to be updated throughout the weekend, so check back in to see if anything has been added. I'll be highlighting my favorite things in bold so you guys can know what my picks will happen to be. And if you happen to click any of these links, they are affiliate links. They do earn me a commission if you make a sale, so that's much appreciated. But none of this content or the deals today are sponsored. This is all just stuff that I looked up and found on my own, and I thought, hey, that's a good price for that, so I wanted to share it with you guys. Thanks again for watching. And one of the biggest Black Friday deals going on right now is the sale on paulshardware.net, where we have our end of the year sale going on. So check that out if you want to get some high quality merchandise and also get a bit of a discount to end the year. Happy holidays. Thanks for watching. We'll see you all in the next video.